Okay. Assalamu alaikum. Today we will study soil biology, and we must know that the soil is alive. It is the home of so many creatures, and 1 teaspoon of the soil contains about 7 billion living body, and the biology or the soil life, we can classify the soil life as microfauna, or first as fauna and the flora. Fauna and the flora. Fauna belongs to the kingdom of animal kingdom. Flora belongs to plant kingdom. For the fauna, we can classify it as microfauna, which is represented by earthworms, the most important one, which we will focus on our study, earthworm. Then mesofauna, which contains nematodes, arthropods, and the microfauna, which contains protozoa. This is the figure showing some of the fauna in the soil. Some of them like earthworms, as we see here, earthworms, mesofauna, ants, mesofauna, and the microfauna, such as nematodes and so on. This also the pictures of some of the fauna in the soil. The functions of fauna or earthworms in the soil, that we have so many functions. Number one, important in mixing and redistributing organic matter, enhances the soil physical properties, neutralizes soil pH, increases the availability of many nutrients, stimulates microbial population, reduces levels of harmful nematodes. So it is very important function for the earthworms in the soil. Yes, this is the picture of earthworm in the soil, and it borrows the soil and they make tunnels like this. And this is very important for many things, as we mentioned. Besides, it aerates the soil and encourages the exchange of soil air. About the nematodes or soil mesofauna or nematodes, its functions that is microscopic non-segmented round worm, ecologically diverse, found in all habitats. Overall, about 20 million, it's counted about 20 million per square meter, a major consumer group, both free living and the parasitic group. Some of them beneficial and some of them parasitic. These are the mesofauna types, the nematodes, the protozoa, and the mites. The main functions are here, important for residue decomposition, predation, pathogens. for the protozoa, it is important in mineralization and the embolization of nitrogen, phosphorus, and the sulfur. Most numerous soil fauna prey on microbes, especially bacteria, enhances nitrification rates, suppresses bacterial and fungal pathogens, can be an agent of plant disease. The soil flora classes, we have macroflora and microflora. The macroflora is the normal plants. The microflora contains bacteria, actinomyces, fungi, and algae. These are the photos of microflora and microorganisms in the soil, fungi, bacteria, and algae. About bacteria, they are the most numerous in the soil, most diverse metabolism, can be aerobic or anaerobic, optimal growth at pH between 6 and 8, this is very important. Examples of bacteria is nitrosomonas, nitrobacter, which are very important in nitrification process, and also nitrogen fixers and bacterium azotobacter. Soil is alive. We must know that soil is alive, not dead. 1 gram of soil contains 100 million bacteria cells, 11,000 pieces of bacteria, also fungi and larger animals. So soil is alive and we must keep it alive. About actinomyces, it is a transitional group between bacteria and the fungi, active in degrading more resistant organic compounds. Optimal growth at alkaline site, take care of this. Actinomyces had optimal growth at alkaline pH. It produces important product like antibodies and geogesmin, negative impact on potato as streptomyces scabies and the brown disease. This is the actinomyces. It is a kind of a bacterial filamentous bacterial cell, grow like fungi, degrade the calcium compounds, chitin, cellulose, and active at higher pH levels. Some produce antibiotics and the streptomyces. For the fungi, dominates in soil biomass, obligate aerobic, can survive desiccation, dominate in acid soil. Fungi prefer acid soil, acid conditions, low pH. Negative impacts make diseases to apple and some fungal diseases for other plants. Beneficial, some of them beneficial like penicillium. Penicillium very important in producing antibiotic. This is the photos of some fungi. And this is photos of some algae, cyanobacteria, diatoms, lichens, and all of them can be make a photosynthesis and form sugars, which is motivating the other creatures to be activated. The relative abundance of all the groups we mentioned, the according to the number, bacteria is found in the highest number, fungi, protozoa, nematodes, arthropods, earthworms, and these are in descending order. According to the numbers, as we notice, according to the weight, the abundance, the relative weight, according the relative abundance, according to weight, the most dominant one is fungi, as you see here, fungi, followed by earthworm, followed by bacteria, followed by nematodes, and so other creations. But the abundance according to number, that it is different. Bacteria is followed by actinomycetes, followed by fungi, followed by algae, protozoa, nematodes, earthworm. So I can ask you here to rearrange the soil biology components according to their number or according to their weight in the soil. There is a beneficial interaction between the soil life and the plant roots. It has symbiotic association such as that found in rhizobia. Rhizobia fixing gas nitrogen and they give us by legumes and they give us nitrogen. Fungi, mycorrhizal association also important for water and the phosphorus uptake. Earthworms improve permeability and aeration. Some other negative interactions, it causes some diseases to some plants.